Hey everyone, how to lose body fat without going to a gym. Now, I love gyms. It's a part of me, it's a part of my everyday routine. But a lot of you might not, and a lot of you might be trying to figure out, I just don't feel comfortable getting into a gym yet. Maybe you want to lose some weight before getting into a gym. Maybe you feel insecure. These are normal points that I discuss with people in my community every single day. So how are we gonna get that ball rolling a little bit? How are we gonna get you feeling better without having to show up to a gym? Because my goal one day is, yeah, I want you to want more. I want you to try and reach. I want you to try and achieve more in your health and wellness journey. All right, everyone, and in no specific order of importance, I'm gonna list several points that are gonna help you outside of the gym. The first one, pay attention to NEAT, N-E-A-T. Non-exercise activity thermogenesis. So to break it down into very simple layman terms, steps. Let's start focusing on trying to get more steps. Now, if you're someone who've only gotten in about 1,000 steps a day, 2,000 steps a day, let's try and push it a little bit. Let's try and take that up 1,000. My goal for most people, yes, is that 10,000 steps per day. Now, improvement is very positive. If you are turning around and you are getting a very low number of steps, I'm not expecting you to go from 1,000 steps a day to 10,000 steps. But I think the idea is activity. I think the idea is movement. I think the idea is getting you out of that chair sitting. Set an alarm on your watch or on your phone and make sure you're not sitting more than 30 minutes at a clip, because this is gonna help your metabolism pick up. This is gonna help your body unwind a bit. You're gonna feel looser. You're gonna feel more mobile and your metabolism is going to pick up. Cutting processed foods 6.5 days a week. Now that's just a term that I use. What do I mean by this? We are going to be feeling like we're giving up a lot of things that we love. And I don't want you to do that. I believe in moderation, but I also believe in some consistency. So when you're starting a new nutritional plan, we need you to kind of start following some guidelines in the beginning. We can't be having cheat meals every other day. We need our body to be able to react and respond. So cut everything processed. Cut white flour, white bread, sugar, sodas. All that stuff can get out of your lifestyle 6.5 days a week, and one meal a week. You can go in and have pizza or ice cream or hamburgers, blow it out for one meal. But this isn't about being perfect all the time. This is about building some consistency. And you'll figure it out. You're gonna start feeling great for those 6 days a week. Maybe you'll start cutting back on that one meal a week. Maybe you wanna go to once every 2 weeks. So this isn't about you removing everything that you love, but this is about setting a plan that's attainable. And I see it with New Year's resolutions all the time. You guys, and it's happened to you. The first of the year hits, you wanna try and be perfect. You're perfect for 2 or 3 weeks. Out of nowhere, you have a blowout night or a blowout weekend. You see you put 3 or 4 pounds of water back on because you're doing no carbs, and it's called yo-yo dieting. And there's no consistency being built or established. So my advice to you is this: don't remove it completely. Give yourself some little checkpoints, some little goals, have some fun. In time, allow that consistency to take place. You will see improvement. This is a long-term approach, and who knows, maybe you're gonna wanna eliminate the cheats even more than 2 weeks. It all comes down to how you're feeling and your success. You be the one to decide. All right, guys, hydration. So most of you out there are dehydrated, you don't even know it, especially if you're drinking alcohol, all right? So first thing you gotta pay attention to is getting half of your body weight in ounces of water. So I'm 210 pounds. I'm gonna consume at least 105 ounces of water a day. If you weigh 150 pounds, that's 75 ounces. If you weigh 100 pounds, that's 50 ounces, all right? So it's all contingent upon body weight. So a couple of things adding water into your daily routine is gonna do. One, it's gonna speed up your metabolism. It's gonna flush out impurities because water detoxes the body. And it's also gonna help us with water retention. So if you feel fleshy and you're holding a lot of water, the water is gonna actually help flush a lot of water out of your body. You're gonna have less of that subcutaneous water retention. So guys, this is something that you should be starting heavier earlier in the day. So try and consume 1/4 of your daily water consumption first thing in the morning when you wake up, because you're breaking a fast and you're already dehydrated. And a little tip, you can add 1 pinch of Celtic salt or pink Himalayan salt to your water first thing in the morning. It's gonna get your digestive system primed and ready to go. Sleep quality, probably one of the most overlooked fat burners. First off, it's free. I'm stealing Paul Check's line. He said it years ago, sleep is free. Okay, I've had a client once who went away for 3 weeks. His nutrition stayed the same. His hydration stayed the same. his activity levels stay the same. He increased his sleep by roughly 90 minutes a night and lost close to 9 pounds in 3 weeks. Okay? So our bodies repair during sleep. We put muscle on while we're sleeping and recovering. Our bodies heal throughout that sleep process. Our hormones heal and become stronger. Our bodies become more efficient. More efficient with energy, more efficient with fat burning. So if you're one of these people that thinks you need less than 7 hours of sleep, I'm gonna test you right now, try and slowly increase that total number of sleep, and then we're gonna wanna make sure that we're improving sleep quality. We can do that by using things that quantify that, like Oura Ring, et cetera. So guys, improve your sleep might be one of the most important tips I'm ever telling you. So protein, so important. From a foundational standpoint, I like revolving everything around protein when it comes to my nutrition. Because carbs and fats, which are your energy sources, might need to be manipulated day in and day out, but protein's that one area that's always consistent. And I think the standard guideline that we should all be following, male or female, is 1 gram per pound, all right? I had a quick little story. Last winter, I was playing hockey 5 days a week. I was working out 5 to 6 days a week, and I wasn't getting enough calories in. My nutrition was high quality. I was still getting protein in, but it was still a little bit low. And because of the amount of activity that I had, I actually lost a pound of muscle and gained a pound of fat. So even though I was eating really good, my nutrition wasn't where it needed to be. My protein was falling a little bit low. Once I was able to assess that through a DEXA scan over the next 6 months, I was able to bump my protein, increase my energy sources, and I was able to drop 8 pounds of fat and put on 2 pounds of muscle. So if you wanna burn fat, really, and you wanna start with a nutrition plan, you really need to start revolving your daily nutritional, you know, intake around protein. Make sure that protein is significant. You don't have to overdo it. 1 gram of protein per pound, which means if you weigh 150 pounds, about 150 grams of protein. If you weigh 200 pounds, around 200 grams of protein to start. And we can always go a little bit north of that if we need to make sure that we're bumping your calories, okay? Couple that with a good amount of fats and carbohydrates, and you're gonna have a really sound nutrition plan. And guys, trust me, getting your nutrition in place is one of my number one focuses, that and sleep. If I'm able to get my nutrition in place and my sleep in place, the gym comes at a third, because we can achieve a healthy lifestyle. We can achieve fat loss, high levels of energy, better sleep quality, better vitality without being in the gym, even though the gym is something that I really enjoy. So guys, which one of these tips do you have to work on? And there might be another tip that I didn't list that you're trying to work on. So what I'd love you to do is this: make sure you subscribe to this channel and comment below. I'd love to hear your thoughts.